Good evening, teacher.
Hello, good evening. How are you?
Bye.
Okay.
Good evening.
Hello.
Hello, teacher.
Hi, how are you?
I'm fine. And you?
Ready. I'm ready.
Okay.
Good evening, teacher.
Hello, what is the name?
Hello, teacher.
Hi, how are you? Glad to see you again.
I'm fine, thank you. And you?
I'm okay. Okay, let me see. Only 9. Hi, how are you, Oscar Arnulfo? How are you?
Hello, teacher. I'm fine. And you?
Nice.
Okay, okay. Ember. Ready for the class.
Yeah, yeah. Ember is like, he's driving or something like that.
Hello, teacher.
Are you driving?
Good evening. Yes, teacher. I'm driving.
Jesus. Be careful. Be careful.
I go to home.
Ah, okay. Tenga cuidado. Tenga cuidado, por favor. Carlos Javier Crespin, how are you?
I'm fine. Thank you, teacher.
Okay. Okay. You? Nice.
Excellent. Excellent.
Okay. Welcome back, Luis Alfonso Martinez Perez. Tiene muteado el fono.
Sorry, teacher. How are you, teacher? Good evening.
Hello, good evening. I got 14, okay. We are going to start now because we need to use the time in the right way. Let me check up the assistant now, please. Veamos la asistencia. Okay, Ana Beatriz.
Present, teacher.
Okay, it's there. Thank you, Blanca Elizabeth.
Present, teacher.
Carlos Alfredo.
Present, teacher.
Okay, Carlos Antonio.
Present.
Welcome. Cristian Ernesto.
Thank you.
Present, teacher.
Claudio.
Present.
Grisel.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Edwin.
Present.
Ember.
Present.
Okay. Elmer Waldo. Elmer. Gonzalo.
Present, teacher.
Elizabeth. Luis Alfonso.
Present, teacher.
Okay, welcome. Luis Manuel. Luis Manuel. Manuel. Not here. María Elena.
I'm here.
Okay. Nelson. Nelson.
I'm here.
Okay, okay. Oscar Arnulfo.
Present, present.
Omar Francisco. Omar.
Teacher, is it?
Is it?
Is it?
Ah, okay. Walter.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Jenny. Jenny. Ana Judith. Judith. Carlos Javier.
Present, Carlos. Teacher.
Okay. Present. Eduardo Guzmán.
Hello, teacher. Good evening.
Hello.
How are you?
Fine. Juan Carlos Rivas. Juan Carlos Rivas no ha aparecido. No ha aparecido. Carla Marisol Escobar. It's not here too. Okay. Bueno. Pasada la lista, we are going to start. Welcome back to this class. In order to start with this class, we are going to remember the topic that we were studying yesterday. Para iniciar, vamos a recordar algunas cosas que estuvimos hablando el día de ayer. Algunos se quedaron pendientes con la conversación que hicieron al final. No sé si alguna pareja quisiera hacer la conversación. O ya se les olvidó.
No, teacher.
No se les ha olvidado.
No, no.
Ok.
Participa con Ana Beatriz.
Ah, ok. Con Ana Beatriz.
Ok, don Luis. Inicio. Hello, Luis. My name is Beatriz Campos.
Hi. Hi, how are you?
Good. I have heard the list on the activities you have to do. First, learn the word are the procedures manual. Second, the importance of manufacturing the practice. It tells the importance of occupational safety.
Okay, where do I have to?
In the conference room, you have to be receiving the training.
Thank you for the information, my boss.
With pleasure. Finish, teacher.
Okay, with pleasure.
Only that, teacher.
Okay, nice. Congratulations.
Thank you, Anna.
You did.
Thank you, Dan Luis. Thank
very
you,
well. Teacher. Okay, 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 okay. Somebody else? De los que se me quedaron ayer, por favor. Hello.
Teacher.
¿No?
Blanca, no sé si gustaría participar.
Blanquita, ¿ya está lista?
Ok. You're a star, Blanca.
Cuando le llama, dice, ya está lista.
Hello, my name is Blanca. Welcome. How are you?
Hi, how are you?
I'm fine. I have heard the list of activities you have to do.
¿Qué me va a poner a hacer?
No. Check an email and make the coffee.
Yes, sir, no problem.
Thank you.
Gracias, Blanca.
Thank you.
Okay, somebody help, please. ¿Alguien más que hace falta? ¿No? ¿Ya nadie? Ah, okay. Okay, 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 okay. Okay, let us start now talking about something new. Let me see. Okay, I consider the topic that we studied yesterday, you have it very clear. I believe that. I believe that. Okay. Let me give me a moment. Yes, I need to open something here. Okay, let me show you this first in order that you can get familiar with what I'm talking about. Okay, today we are going to study Ken for information and possibility, okay? Okay, we have a question. You are going to ask a classmate what the product they started and where they can start in. I don't know if you can get the meaning. And I got some picture here. I got a platform trap and a hand trap. Could you tell me how can I use it? When can I use it?
For transportation, t-shirt and box.
Okay.
Para cartas.
Ah, okay, okay, okay. Okay, let us talk about the product that you have in your companies that you store, and where you can start it. Or we can talk about different items that you have in your houses. Yeah. But before that, let me show you some pictures that I need to show you. In big companies, we can have different way how to put it. Also, we can use star beams, fire protective partitions. And also we use pallets, you know, different item that we can use in order to start something. We have different way how to quicken and start something like column, like square, and also like a pyramid in different ways like that. And we have this one like a step, triangle, or link to a step. But let us talk first of all about what do you have in your houses or in your company that we can start. Hablemos de todos aquellos artículos que usted tiene en su casa y que los tiene almacenados o en su compañía incluso. Hello.
Well, in my case, the storage and every product, white line, refrigerator, and other products. TV is a storage. It's a storage.
Okay. Somebody else?
I am is motorcycle teacher in my house.
Okay, motorcycles.
TV también. Solamente pues.
Okay, talking about the motorcycle, if you don't have a space in the garage, where can you put it on?
En español.
Si ya no tiene espacio para guardarla en el garage, ¿dónde la pondría?
No sé cómo decir de patio, teacher.
Podría ser en the patio.
Ahí está ahorita en el patio.
Is there?
Okay, teacher.
Okay. What about the rest? They don't want to talk about what they saw in their houses.
Me. Okay. In my case, we have the spare parts in the ordinals in the shelves.
Ah, shelves, okay.
Shelves.
I got it.
Yes. Not only that, no, I have much articles.
Okay. What about the rest?
Me, teacher.
Tell me, Amber.
In my case, in my house, had around 220 refrigerator and washing machine.
Okay. Do you have a hardware store or something like that?
Repeat, please.
Do you have a, tiene una bodega donde tenerla, or do you have a special place to have it?
Yes, I have a storage.
Okay.
In front of my house.
Okay, excellent. Somebody else, please.
In my case, teacher, in my company, the stock is Sparry Park. It's, okay. There are storage in a stand because our small product, okay?
A small product,
okay. Only that, teacher.
Okay. What else? Try to see around you now if you have something there, how you have it. If you have some material like, for example, paper or something like that, where do you have it? Okay, let us go straight to the point. In your company, maybe some of you have a different kind of items in a storage place. Okay, let us read some features about this. Talking about product, for example, we are going to study with the weight, the dimension, and the quantity. Imagine that we have tablets and the weight is 170 grams. The dimension is 19.3 centimeter by 13.7 centimeter by 1.03 centimeter, okay? This is the dimension. And the quantity we have 200. And the question maybe could be, how can I store it? And also we have television, and the weight is 112.43 pounds. The dimension 41.3 inches by 26.7 inches. And we have 100. And also we have refrigerator, the weight is 340 pounds or could be 380 pounds. And the dimension could be 48 and 1/8. And the quantity we have 50. The question is how I'm going to arrange all this product in a storage. How can I do it? Give me some ideas, how can I do it? If I have a tablet, I have television and refrigerator. It is possible that I can do it alone. Only one person can move all that item, or I need some help?
Need help.
Okay.
One person is impossible.
Okay, impossible.
I need more people.
Okay. Can I do it by hand, or I need to use a leaf or another kind of machine to do it?
Different kind of machine.
Ah, okay.
Teacher, ¿lo puede explicar en Spanish, please?
En español y a colores, ¿cómo no? Ok, estamos hablando de diferentes productos. Estamos viendo el peso, la dimensión y la cantidad. ¿Sí? Tenemos tablet, que el peso de ella es 170 gramos, con una dimensión de 19.3 centímetros por 13.7 centímetros por 1.03 centímetros. Esa es la dimensión de las tablets. De ellas tengo 200. Al mismo tiempo tengo 100 televisores que andan en un peso de 112.43 libras con una dimensión de 41.3 pulgadas por 26.7 pulgadas, que en inglés es inch. De esas tengo 100. Y refrigeradoras, el peso anda de 340 libras a 380. La dimensión de ellas son de 48 y un octavo de pulgada. Y la cantidad que tengo son 50. Ahora la pregunta es, ¿cómo voy a hacer para mover todo este producto? ¿Será posible? ¿Será posible que una sola persona lo va a hacer? ¿Voy a tener que utilizar algún tipo de maquinaria para hacerlo?
No. Yes.
Okay. Tell me.
You need the truck.
Okay. Imagine that the delivery is there in the company. Llegó, me la llegaron a dejar a la mercadería ahí. Yo tengo que recibirla, ¿no? But how I'm going to do it to move it to a storage? ¿Cómo voy a hacer?
Nunca me han manejado un camión.
I suppose that the product is in the boxes.
Yeah, Oscar, it is.
You can use leaf.
I can use leaf, but also I can use Do you remember the picture that I showed you at the beginning?
The palette.
Yeah, could be palette, but also I need something with wheels. Pero también puedo necesitar una herramienta que tenga ruedas para poder mover eso. Do you remember the name?
Yeah, sería...
And palette troop, teacher?
No,
teacher.
I show you here. We can use platform trap or hand trap, you know?
But it depends on the space that you can...
Hand truck.
Platform trap.
Yeah, all depend on the...
Hand truck.
Yeah, all depend on the, in the place we are going to put it, right?
Yes, it's a bit, for example.
Yeah, okay, go ahead. Tell me.
For example, in the industry that I work, move a different material.
Okay.
In different areas, you use platform trucks.
Okay.
But with this material, sale, I don't know, how do you say?
Sale?
Sale en del... del área.
Okay.
We finish the process. Use lift to move the other build.
Ah, to another build. Okay.
Yes. For okay. me, it depends.
Okay.
And in different case, only one person move all material, or four person more.
Okay. 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 Okay, excellent. Somebody else, please.
In my case, teacher,
you can move.
How can I do it?
Teacher, estoy levantando la manita.
Ah, Carlos Antonio Hernández. Sí, como estaba hablando ahí antes, Gonzalo, creo.
For example, when the tablet or the tablet are the 10 inch.
Yes.
And the quantity 200 is our much. For the ordinals is the shelving, for example.
Yeah, could be.
Yes.
Okay, let us talk about possibilities. And you say, okay, I can put it in shelves, okay? I can put it in shelves, in your case, you said that way. But somebody else could say, okay, talking about television, what I can do is this. Yeah, and talking about refrigerator, what I can do is this. Or somebody could say, alguien podría decir, okay, before to move it, I need to ask to my principal, to my boss, to my share manager, to ask him or her where I'm going to put it. Okay? Eso sería otra opción. Antes de moverlo, tengo que preguntarle, ya sea al supervisor, al gerente, al encargado, dónde voy a ponerlo. ¿Ya?
In the box.
They are in boxes, maybe. Okay. Se me quedaron durmiendo. ¿Qué pasó? No me están encajando en el tema.
Cargando está la memoria.
De seguro porque estamos viendo los números ahí. Okay, veamos aquí. Focus our attention in this. Read the conversation again to answer the question. Okay, can one person install all the television? One cell? ¿Será posible eso?
¿Puede no, una...
Yes.
No.
Una persona no podría moverlos.
Okay, tell me in English, the reason.
Where is the meaning one cell?
One cell, el mismo.
Sorry, teacher. I see one television.
Okay. Can one person solo the television oneself? Yes or not?
Yes, I can. Or oh, yes, he can. Yes. But yes. The tie is very long. Yes.
Bye.
Yeah, all depend. Todo depende de lo que dijo ahí la compañera. En el área donde se va a ubicar. De eso dependerá. Okay, what about the second one? Where can you store 50 refrigerators? ¿Dónde puede usted almacenar 50 refrigeradoras? Tell me.
I can store in the ratchet.
Okay, somebody else.
In the warehouse.
Yeah, but I need that you tell me the whole sentence. Que me dé una respuesta completa. I mean that you are going to say, okay, I can start it in, okay. So, and then number three said, can you store the tablet on shelves?
Yes, you can. Yes, I can.
Okay, tengo dos participantes levantando la mano, pero no veo sus nombres, pero voy a detenerlo. Okay. Ahí tengo a Carlos Javier Crespin. Tell me, Carlos. And then, y después ya la bajó quien tenía la mano arriba también. Carlos, Javier, desmute.
Yes, teacher. Con los 50 refrigerators in the company warehouse. You can ahí.
Okay, you can put it there. Okay, remember that you are going to use I. Okay, I can. In my case, I can put it in because we are talking about possibilities. Okay, somebody else, please. ¿Alguien más que me diga cómo, dónde ponemos las tablets, dónde ponemos las refrigeradoras? No sé, pero hay algo.
Refrigerator, teacher. Okay. In the big seller.
Ah, hay algo que no han notado. Les voy a poner la pregunta de nuevo para que sean observadores. Póngale atención a las preguntas. Hay algo ahí en cada una de las preguntas. Y ese es el main topic for us.
I can.
Okay. Grisel, tell me.
I can store 50 refrigerators in my patios. Because it's very big.
Okay. Nice. Easy.
This is my possibility.
Yeah, it's your possibility. Yeah. But somebody else has another possibility. That is what I want to explore in you. Esa es la posibilidad que tiene Grisel. Pero en el caso, por ejemplo, de Carlos Antonio, puede tener otra posibilidad. José Eduardo tiene otra posibilidad. Claudio tiene otra posibilidad. Cristian Ernesto tiene otra posibilidad. Eso es lo que yo necesito que ustedes me digan. ¿Dónde guardarían 50 refrigeradoras? Jenny Zulaima, tell me.
Ay, teacher. Ay, me acabo de conectar.
Okay. Hold on. Don't worry. Relax. Sí, no me gusta agarrar así a nadie el quemarropa. I'm sorry. Okay, ¿alguien más, please? Juan Carlos.
What are you doing, teacher?
What can you tell me about? Where can you store 50 Refrigerator.
The refrigerator in
yes.
the house.
Yeah, but where?
In the living room.
Okay, but I mean that you use the expression, the possibility. There is a keyword, hay una palabra clave que vamos a usar cuando vamos a referirnos a una posibilidad.
I can.
Ah, okay.
I can put the 50 refrigerator in my living room.
Okay, okay. Excelente.
I can put the 50 refrigerator in Amber home.
Where?
I can put refrigerator in the Amber house.
Amber house.
I have a 15 refrigerator in my house.
Oh, you have it.
He sell it.
Yeah.
Yes. And 20 washer machine.
Okay. Ah. Okay. Okay. Okay, let us continue talking about.
Maybe I can keep it in a cellar.
Can?
Maybe I can keep it in a cellar.
Ah, you can keep it, okay. Okay, how we are going to use can for information and possibility, okay. We are going to take, I need that you take into account this information. Okay, let us study first. When we are going to use can for information. When we are going to use it for information, we are going to use a WH word question, but in this case, I have only just two words here for the example. Where can you stock all the new product? Or when can you? Yeah, could be where can she, where can we, where can they? This is for information. And when we are talking about possibility, we say, if we are going to ask a question, can you stop all the new products? Can I, can he, can she, can we, can they? ¿Se comprende cuándo usamos can para información y cuándo para posibilidad?
Yes.
Observen. Ahora relacionémoslo con las refrigeradoras, con los televisores y las tablets.
Teacher, have a question. The verb put is okay used in the sentence. In this case, I can put these 50 refrigerators.
Yes, we can use it, but in this case, we are focused our attention in this only yes and can. And later on, we are going to, because if you say, I could do it. Es cierto, siempre sería como posibilidad, pero ya sería en una forma diferente. ¿Sí?
Okay.
But in this case, we are just using a can. If I, if I ask you where you can store 200 tablets, where can you stock all the new tablets? Where can be the answer?
I can stock in my desk.
Yeah, could be one possibility.
Okay.
Okay, but let us talk about all the items that you have in your houses using this information that I already showed you. Okay, try to use in both ways. But first of all, focus our attention in information. Let us focus our attention in can for information. try to ask a question using can. Ok, imagínense que ustedes trabajan en el delivery, llega a una empresa, ¿cómo preguntaría a usted dónde va a poner el producto?
I can.
No, because where it's a question.
Where can you put the article or the food?
Of food.
Okay. Tenemos que ordenar las ideas. ¿Sí? Okay, Grisel.
Se podría decir, where can I put or store this object?
Yeah, could be. For example. One option. Esa es una opción, pero hay montones de opciones. Ok, ¿alguien más que me diga otra?
Teacher, could you... Yes.
Tell me.
Yeah.
Tell me, José Eduardo. Hello.
No, le preguntaba, could you, podría usted, si no.
But you are asking me a question, or the way that you are going to ask the question in the company?
The question and the company.
Ah, okay. Recuerde que siempre vamos a usar una palabra WH antes. Ya, where can I, ¿dónde puedo yo? ¿Ya?
Ok, dicho.
Ahora recordemos que el can, al traducirlo es poder, pero acuérdense que en este nivel lo vamos a usar también como una posibilidad, ¿no? Así como cuando se usa en algunas preguntas, en un tanto informal que alguien dice, can I go out? ¿Sí? Can I leave now? ¿Me puedo ir ya? Talking about that, you know. Ok, pero lo que necesito es que piensen que vayamos creando oraciones usando el can. Primero, para obtener información.
Ok.
Piense. Ahorita veo ahí así cómo sale el poder. Bueno, yo creo que ya todos se ubicaron en el tema que tenemos, ¿sí?
Teacher.
Tell me. Gonzalo.
Can I put on the table this book?
Ah. Can I?
Put on the table this book.
Can I put?
This one.
Can I put this book on the table?
Okay. Thank you.
Okay. Imagínense que a las señoras o señoritas se les olvidó que era un día especial hoy y de repente llegan de una floristería. ¿Cómo les preguntan? Ellos van con un arreglo floral. Vamos a ver, recuérdense la última vez que le mandaron flores. No les creo, no les creo. ¿Cómo les dijo el de la floristería?
We're looking.
Ya, yeah, no, aparte de que cuando llegó a preguntar por la persona, si imaginemos que todos ustedes tienen una oficina y que él llegó a la oficina, ¿qué les dijo?
Wrong word. No.
Can I help you?
Vámonos al punto que ya ustedes ya se identificaron, él ya las encontró. Él ya las encontró y él necesita entregarle las flores, el arreglo floral que lleva.
Cool.
¿Sí?
Can you send the flower for me?
No. Ya hablaron.
Where can you
maybe where can I put your flowers?
Ah, okay. When where can I put it? ¿Dónde se las puedo poner? ¿Dónde se las puedo dejar? Ahí está, verdad, que ya se les olvidó. Ahí está el detalle. Y ahí el detalle. Ok, imagine that you bought a new bed. Imagínese que compró una nueva cama. And suddenly the delivery arrived to your house. Y de repente llega el camión a dejarle la cama. ¿Qué le pregunta? ¿Carlos Javier?
Where can I leave her net bed?
Again, please. Otra vez, dígamelo otra vez, por favor.
Teacher. Okay. Where can I leave her new bed?
Where can I put it? Or where are you going to put it? When I can leave it? ¿Dónde la puedo dejar? Okay, ¿alguien habló? ¿Alguien habló por ahí? Está fácil. Y estamos hablando ahorita solo de información. Acuérdese que usted necesita tener información.
Where can you put your product?
Ah, could be. Ahora, nos hemos enfocado solo en producto, pero esa palabra can. Si yo necesito información, imagine that suddenly, let me see, you need to buy something, but you don't know where you can get it. Usted necesita comprar algo, pero usted no sabe dónde obtenerlo. And you are going to ask to somebody else. Pero usted le preguntará a alguien más cómo lo haría.
Where can I buy?
And then you are going to mention the name of the item that you need to buy. Or where can I find?
Teacher, or can you tell me where they buy it, the shoes, for example?
Where can I buy?
Okay.
Yeah. Imagine that you need a new tire for your cars, and you are going to ask somebody, oh, where can I buy it? ¿Dónde puedo comprar una buena llanta para mi carro? Sí, entonces está sacando información. Y alguien le va a dar una respuesta de una posibilidad. Yeah, you can go to Impresa Repuesto, you can go to Didea, etc., 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 you know? Easy. Or not easy? But the main purpose of us is talking about a product in your companies. Imagínense que usted tiene un pedido de no sé qué es lo que comercializan en algunas empresas de ustedes. Pero imagínense que usted tiene un pedido de 200 cajas y que todas las bodegas están llenas. You need to talk to somebody else to ask how you are going to do it. Hola.
Where can I have these boxes?
Ah, okay. You can get...
Where can I put this box?
Okay, tomorrow I'm going to get 200 boxes with product. Where can I put it? Okay, okay. Por ahí vamos.
For example, teacher, where can I leave this stationery for you?
Ah, okay. Okay. Por ahí vamos entrando ya en tema. Somebody else?
Puede ser, when can I pick up my order?
Ah, okay. Could be a question. Not talking about product, but if you have another, you can ask the question. Okay, you are... Okay, excuse me, go ahead.
Where can I get a box of chocolate?
Ah, okay, chocolate.
Chocolate.
Okay, let me see something.
Maybe, where can I stock the boxes?
Yeah, could be. Yeah, you remember that you can use a different WH word, all depend on the question that you are going to ask for to get information, yeah? And also, if you want to talk about possibility, you can use can. Can they work until 7? ¿Pueden ellos trabajar hasta las 7? Because we need to... have this product done. Necesitamos terminar este producto. Okay. Okay. In exercise number 5, we are going to read the following statement to write a question about it. Okay. You can start it in the back room. How is going to be the question? ¿Cómo será la pregunta? Si la respuesta dice, you can start it in the back room. Los puede almacenar allá en el cuarto del fondo. Or, yes, she can. She can sign the form. And I got the number 3. No, we can. We can move all the televisions. And the number 4 said they can pile up the boxes tomorrow. Ah, okay. Ojo con las terminaciones. Number 5, you can store the night. 90 cars on our warehouse. And number 6, yes, I can. I can give you information on the product. How I'm going to create the questions. Try to think about this. Number 1, how can I do it? ¿Cómo podría ser la pregunta de la número 1?
When I can restore the product.
Yeah, could be. Another way? Vamos, piense. The answer is you can start in the bathroom. ¿Cómo será entonces la pregunta?
can you store, teacher? Can you store them in the bathroom?
Yeah, could be in that way, but we need to add something else. Necesitamos agregarle algo más. Grisel.
Where can I store the this product, for example?
Yes, okay. Listen. Where can I store this product? Está preguntándole el lugar exacto y le dice, you can store them in the back room. Yeah. Okay, what about number two? Yes, she can. She can sign the form. ¿Cómo sería la pregunta? Ah, okay, we need to go back. Veamos si nos vamos de regreso. Perdón.
Can she sign this form, please?
Ah, exacto. Observemos la forma que tiene acá, que primero uso can, después el pronombre personal y después el complemento. Grisel, tell me, Grisel.
In this case, sería, can we move all the television?
You are talking about number? Ah, you are talking about number three, but... Yeah, could be in that way. Because it's a possibility.
I'm sorry. I
Yeah, but no problem. Okay, could you repeat please the number three?
Can we move all the television?
Okay, en ese caso, ¿está hablando de información o de posibilidad? Perdón.
Possibility.
De posibilidad. ¿Por qué? Porque está haciendo una pregunta para ver si es posible o no es posible. Okay. And the number two. Somebody answer this. Can she
sing the form?
Can she sign the form?
Sign the form.
Yeah. ¿Puede ella firmar el formulario? Yes, she can. She can sign the form. ¿Y eso es posibilidad o información?
Possibility.
Okay, possibility. Number four. They can pile up the boxes tomorrow. How is the question? Tell me.
When can they fill up the boxes?
When can they pile up the boxes? Okay. Por ahí vamos entendiendo ya, mire. Número cinco. You can store the night cars on a warehouse. Primero tengo que ver information o possibility, dependiendo de la pregunta. Tell me, please.
Possibility.
Possibility?
Information.
Okay, how can you ask the question? ¿Cómo sería?
Where can you store the 19 cars?
Okay, estamos sacando información, ¿sí? When can I store the 9 cars? Okay. And the last one, number 6, yes I can. I can give you information. What's the problem? Possibility or information?
Possibility.
¿Cómo sería la pregunta?
Can you tell me information for the product?
Ahí hay un
verbo. Can you give me?
Ajá, ok, ahí está. Can you give me? Can you give me some information about the product? Yes, I can give you information about the product. What do you want to know? Tell me how many pounds it weighs. Will you tell me the dimension? Because sometimes we ask for dimension. Algunas veces cuando compramos un producto preguntamos por las dimensiones porque ya tenemos el espacio donde lo vamos a... ¿A qué? Where we are going to put it, okay? Y las señoras son bien especiales en eso y dicen, necesito una cocina o una refri de esta medida porque la voy a ubicar en this plate. ¿Ya? ¿O no? Ajá, y tienen una ahí que ya no la quieren y entonces usted les pregunta, okay, but where you are you going to put, or where I can put this old one? ¿Y dónde voy a poner la viejita? ¿Sí? ¿Y cuál es la respuesta?
Put the trash.
Trash bro.
Yeah, could be. Okay, estuviésemos en otro país, le dice, okay, put it in the sidewalk. Ahí déjala en la acera, alguien se la va a pasar llevando. Yeah. Yeah, but right here is different, you know. Okay, but I need that you, necesito que nos centremos en esas dos partes. Mira, está fácil, está sencillo. Usando información y hablando de posibilidades. Ahora, céntrese usted en su empresa y piense en dos cosas. Una pregunta sacando información y otra que sea de posibilidad, pero relacionada con su trabajo. In your company. Los veo pensando, Carlos Javier, Crispin, I don't see your face. Ahí está. Luis Manuel Lender. Ah, ok. We are going to see the attendance again. Vamos a ver la lista otra vez. Porque hay algunos que no me aparecen ahí. Elmer, are you there? No apareció Elmer. Se me ha perdido. Ana Beatriz. Present?
Present, teacher.
Oh, no, present. Okay. Blanca Elizabeth.
Present.
Carlos Alfredo. Carlos Antonio.
Present.
Cristian Ernesto.
Present.
Claudio Iván.
Present.
Grisel.
Present.
Edwin. I don't see you, Edwin. Elmer. Ubaldo Ramírez. Ember.
Present, teacher.
Francisca Elizabeth, please, sorry. Elizabeth Martinez. She's not here. Gonzalo, I saw you.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Luis Alfonso.
Present, teacher.
Luis Manuel.
Present, teacher.
Let me see. María Elena.
I'm here, teacher.
Okay.
Present.
Nelson.
I'm here, teacher.
Omar Francisco. Omar. Omar. No, no está. Oscar Arnulfo.
Present.
Okay. Walter.
Present, teacher.
Jenny. Jenny, I saw
present,
you, Jenny.
Present.
Okay. Ana Judith. Carlos Javier.
Present, teacher.
Jose Eduardo.
Present, teacher.
Juan Carlos.
Present.
Carla Marisol Escobar. No está. Ok, hay varios que no están. Recordemos que la asistencia es muy importante al momento de hacer la contabilidad para poder pasar el módulo. Entonces, por favor, we need to be present and remember that you need to have your cameras on too. Ese es otro de los requisitos que necesitamos tener siempre la cámara encendida. Eso se les explicó desde el inicio. Algunas veces puede ser que por la señal no se permita, pero es necesario tenerla siempre encendida, por favor. Okay, any question about the exercise number 5?
No question.
No questions? Okay. Okay, before to continue, I would like to give you some time in order that you can, now that you know the structure, that you can use it when you are going to ask for information and when you are going to use CAN for possibility. As I told you, I need that you think in two different sentences and you are going to share it with me now, please.
I'm finished.
Okay, could you read it, please?
Okay, for the possibility, can I examine tomorrow the personal program for today?
Okay, and
the information?
Yeah, the information.
Where can they receive the training?
Okay, thank you. Somebody else, please.
In meditation.
Okay, tell me.
And possibly, can you study this day and finish the hub? And information, where you can connect to recite the ISR holiday training.
Okay. Somebody else, please.
Me, teacher.
Tell me.
Information. Where can we make the meeting? In possibility, can I use the meeting room?
I use the meeting room. Okay. Thank you. Somebody else, please.
The third. When can I come back to the office? Possibility, I can evaluate the children tomorrow.
Okay.
Me, teacher.
Tell me, sir.
And can you stay one more hour working? Yes, I can stay one more hour working. And when can you finish this production order? I can finish eating our hour.
In an hour, okay. Okay, somebody else, please.
Hey, teacher.
Blanca?
Can you check how the product is going? The information, when can you stay to work in the afternoon?
Okay. What else? La otra? That's it, Blanca? Okay, somebody help, please. Hurry up, hurry up, hurry up. Wake up, wake up, wake up.
Me, teacher.
Claudio, Mendez, tell me.
Yes. Possibility, can I throw away the shopping book of 2010? Okay. Information, when can I make modification to declaration the taxes?
Oh, and taxes, okay. Talking about taxes. Okay, somebody else, please. I'm waiting, I'm waiting, I'm waiting.
Teacher.
Tell me.
Can you write report tomorrow? And when can I send report?
When can I send your report? Yeah. Okay.
Teacher, possibility.
Possibility.
Can you help me with the meeting next Sunday?
Okay, can you help me? Okay, excellent.
Information, where can she send the report increases and decreases?
Okay, nice. Okay, veamos los que no han participado, por favor. Se me están durmiendo, se me están durmiendo. Hello, 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 hello. Cristian, Ernesto. Nelson Navarrete. Hola, hola. Silencio total. Anybody want to talk about this topic? Bueno, vamos a preguntar así dedocráticamente porque ya veo que no se nos terminaron los voluntarios. Ember Giovanni, are you there? Ember, Ember.
Teacher, en este momento no puedo, mil disculpas.
Ah, okay, okay, okay. Okay. Luis Manuel, Nelson, hello, hola,
hi teacher.
I don't know why anybody wants to participate.
Me, teacher.
Okay, do it, Luis.
Okay, teacher. Possibility, can you pay me tomorrow? And information, when can you give me the report of the invoices?
Okay, se dan cuenta que bien es fácil, es sencillo. No tenemos que complicarnos tanto para hacer uso de esas expresiones. Okay, let me see how many do we have now. Okay, tenemos, oh, we got 19. Okay, I'm going to divide the class in pairs. I'm going to create pairs. Vamos a crear un breakout room. And you are going to work in this. Okay, listen. I'm going to tell you in Spanish para que no nos compliquemos. Okay, imagínense que en su empresa, en su compañía, acaba de llegar un producto. Usted con la otra persona se van a poner de acuerdo dónde lo van a almacenar. That means that you are going to create a conversation. Eso significa entonces que van a crear una conversación que no va a ser solamente la pregunta que le va a decir, where I can put this? No, no, no. You need to establish a conversation related to what you have learned in the previous module, okay? Is that clear enough or no? ¿Está claro qué es lo que vamos a hacer? ¿Está claro?
Yeah, it's clear.
Yes,
clear. Okay, vamos a hacer un role play donde hay un nuevo producto que ha llegado a la compañía y necesitamos direcciones de dónde lo vamos a almacenar. Si alguno se queda solo en el breakout room, ese lo va a tener que hacer conmigo para que así podamos trabajar. Okay. Ah, ok, sí, me gusta. Ok, necesitamos hacer la conversación muy bonita. Let me see. Ok, 20. I'm going to create 10 breakout room. Si necesitamos repetirlo por el tiempo, we are going to do it because of that time. Ok, I'm going to read it. Voy a leerles quién va a trabajar con quién para que así después no esté perdido. En el room 1. Va a trabajar Cristian Ernesto con Jenny Zuleima. En el 1, en su momento que les dé salidas, cada quien va a buscar su lugar que le corresponda. En el room 2, María Elena con Walter Villalta. En el room 3, Ana Beatriz con Ember. Room 4, Luis Alfonso con Luis Muñoz.
Teacher, y Ember ahorita no pudo, no puede trabajar, escuché.
Ok, voy a tomar en cuenta eso por si me queda alguien solo. Ok, Luis Alfonso Martínez con Luis Manuel. Isel con José Eduardo. Nelson con Oscar. Carlos Antonio con Carlos Javier. En el room 8, o sea, el 8, va Carlos Alfredo con Nelson Gavarrete. En el 9, Blanca Elizabeth con Juan Carlos. En el 10, ahí solo estaba Claudio Méndez. Entonces a Claudio lo vamos a enviar para... Déjenme ver. Para donde estaba... Ember Giovanni, creo, ¿sí?
En el 13.
Ya, yeah. en el 3. I'm going to send it. Vamos a enviar a Claudio para el 3. Ahorita en este momento. Ahí está. Ok. Here we go.
Perdón, ¿y qué número me dio, teacher?
Hola.
¿Qué número de room me dio? ¿Qué número de room me dio?
¿Nombre?
Nelson Gabate.
Nelson, en room 6.
Ok.
Ok, ahí vamos. A trabajar. A trabajar ahorita. Hurry up, please, hurry up. Claudio. Luis Manuel necesita irse al room four, please. No sé, José Eduardo se quedó solo. I'm checking. Nelson. Room 8. Grisel, you are alone.
No sé okay. Para el room.
¿Se quedó sola, Grisel?
No, sí tenía pareja, pero no sé cómo. Anteriormente había mandado las invitaciones y hoy no apareció nada.
¿Really? Pero no se recuerda con quién estaba.
No sé si dijo Edgardo. No estoy segura.
No, pero me aparece como que no la asigné.
No, pero sí me mencionó.
Sí, pero ahorita me aparece como que no está asignada. La voy a enviar al 5.
Ok.
Ahí está esperando José Eduardo. Ya le llegó la invitación.
No.
¿Qué es?
No me aparece.
Jesús.
Ah, okay.
Maybe you are having problems with connections. Okay, Nelson is there. Nelson, Oscar is waiting for you, Nelson. Nelson. Okay, in this moment, all the participants are talking about the conversation. They are creating a short conversation about a new product and where they are going to start it. Thank you. Okay, in this moment, they are preparing a role play in which new products have arrived at the company and they need to give direction on where to start them.
Teacher, muy poquito tiempo.
No falta, teacher.
Yeah, I know.
Teacher, no faltó.
Yeah, I know. Lo sé que es muy corto el tiempo, ¿no?
Pero... me quedé, teacher. Con el producto en el lomo me quedé.
En el aire.
Okay, I'm going to do it again. I'm going to give you again. Okay, let me see if I got the same people in the same group. Okay, I got it. Pero traten de usar el tiempo lo más que se pueda, por favor, para que podamos hacer algo bonito. Okay, una vez más y luego lo pueden hacer a través del chat. Ahí se pueden ir comunicando para hacer su role play. Okay, here we go again. Okay, ahí está la invitación. Let us do it now, please. Okay, estamos teniendo problemas solamente con Nelson y con Ember, Giovanni, Polio. But the rest, they are working on the role play. And we did it again because the time is too short. Because I assign only as 120 seconds. And they need more time in order to work on it. For the reason I do it again, now I'm waiting. If we follow the instructions, we are going to be able to create the conversation.
Teacher, creo que me puedes reenviar, por favor, al grupo 7.
In room 7?
Yes, please.
What happened, sir?
Es que cuando envié la notificación, apreté otro botón y me regresó de nuevo. Más que quedé a medias con el compañero.
Vale. I'm trying to do it, but let me see.
¿Qué le hace el tiempo que va muy rápido, teacher?
¿Hola?
¿Qué le hace el tiempo que va muy rápido?
I can hear you very well. I don't know if you are having problem with your connections, but I hear only yes the first words. Only yes a few words, but not the whole message. Will you repeat again, please? Maybe you are asking me because the time is going too fast, I guess. But if what you
no,
told me.
No, solamente dije que muy rápido pasa el tiempo.
Yeah. Eso era lo que estaba diciendo, que sí, el tiempo vuela. Cuando se contabiliza en un breakout, el tiempo no se siente, pues. I know. But you can use the chat in order to continue with the conversation if you want. Or you can, o puede hacer la improvisación si ya tiene más o menos la idea quién va a hacer el papel.
Improvisé. No. Así ya casi está lista, teacher. Ya.
Ya casi la tenemos.
No, ya estuvo. Ya no,
cuatro líneas.
Está completa. Es completa.
Es completa. Teacher, I'm sorry. I find
Nelson Gabarrete. Lo ando buscando todavía.
Ah, man. Oscar, that is true. I saw you. You were alone. Sí, lo vi que estaba solo. And I was trying to talk with Nelson, but it was difficult to get a good communication with him. Okay, Luis, Alfonso.
No sé qué pasó.
Luis.
Perdón, teacher, me pasó porque me mandaron con otro compañero llamado Carlos, pero tenía él loca. No tiene mucha señal. Y no, que me había dicho que era con Oscar.
Sí.
Era una
confusión, una confusión. Ok, no problem.
Yo creo que...
Sí, lo que sí necesito es que estemos de acuerdo, porque necesito que todos hagan la actividad. Si no fue posible que se comunicaron en el breakout room, es difícil, because I need that all of you participate. Luis Alfonso Martinez, I'm sorry. I saw that you was trying to tell me something. Vi que me quería decir algo.
No, teacher, sí, que nosotros sí terminamos con Manuel.
Ah, ok, excelente.
Usted no, pero si puede proyectar la pantalla porque él no tomó nota.
Ah, no tomó nota. Ok.
Ah, no, la pregunta es, teacher, si lo voy a leer uno solo o vamos a participar ambos. Tú, ok.
Sí, porque si no va a ser monólogo.
Ok.
And what we need is a role play, it's going to be for two. Yeah?
Okay. Please, aquí está nuestra conversación, teacher.
Ok, ahí se nos corrió el Luis. Se nos corrió un espacio, Luis.
Sí, pero soy solera.
Okay, you can do it now, please.
Start right. Hi, Manuel. In this moment, it's all right, the new product. Please, you can help me?
Yes. I organized the staff for store the product and where it can stack.
You can stay in the warehouse principal.
And I don't have problem.
Please, this product has to start right now.
Okay.
Only that, teacher. Teacher, only that.
No, en la otra flechita le va a dar. Dejar de compartir.
Sí, cómo no. Ahorita.
Ahí le va a aparecer, dejar de compartir. Ah, ok, excelente, Luis Martinez en compañía. Yeah, we are going to give you an applause. Only one.
Me, teacher.
Okay.
Manuel lo hizo.
Ok. Somebody else, please. Siguiente, por favor.
Mi teacher con...
Ok, Eduardo.
Con Grisel.
Ok.
Hello. Hello, good morning. How are you? Where can I leave the TV?
Hello, I'm fine, thanks. Thanks for coming. You can put the television in the next room, please. Can you install the television too?
Yes, with pleasure.
Thanks for helping me.
Okay. Teacher. Ahí, ¿verdad?
Okay, nice, nice. You need to set the television, yeah. And adjust everything. And get the knob to her.
Okay.
Sí, hasta darle el control. Okay, here you are. Yeah. It's a good service. Okay, somebody else, please.
El servicio completo, sí,
yeah.
Sí.
Yeah, full service. Full service. Okay, somebody else, please.
Me.
Solo llevo cuatro, los llevo contados. Carlos Antonio.
Win. Javier Crespin. Hi, Javier. Hi, Javier.
Hi, Carlos.
We have received a new product.
Okay, what is the product?
The new product is TV.
Okay, the TV is big or small?
The new TVs are big.
How many TVs are you going to receive?
100 TVs.
Where can we keep them?
You can keep in the new warehouse. Only that.
Okay, thank you. Excellent, excellent. Next, please. Siguiente, por favor.
Hi, teacher. We...
María Elena.
Walter. Yes, con Walter.
Walter.
Hello. Hello.
Hi, good morning, Walter. My name is Guadalupe.
Good morning, Mary.
Good morning.
Good morning.
My name is... Good morning. Can you give me information about some teachers?
Excuse me?
Can you give me information about some teachers?
Yes, what do you use? Your service.
I am working in Fundación Educo, and I can with your manager. You send enviaría. Ay, olvidó cómo era.
Send.
Send me 100 t-shirts.
Okay, is my company is a confection t-shirt. What is you how much t-shirt?
100.
Okay, go to $5 in color green and $5 in color turquoise. Are we in the warehouse?
Send me traffic handle street 325.
Okay, are in warehouse, when receive?
Mauricio.
Is you manager?
The manager, yes. Is the manager warehouse, yes.
Okay, I am, I read 10 a.m. for the production.
Excellent.
Okay,
excellent.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. See you soon. Bye bye.
Bye.
Okay, I got a question. If you are asking for information, you can say, okay, who can receive it? Who can receive it there? Who can receive it there?
The product.
Yeah, receiving.
Who can receive it? ¿Quién puede recibirlos? Y la otra cosa es que no sé si estaban hablando de nombre contable o no contable, porque la pregunta que hizo dijo how much.
Sí, pero después me especificó ella del número de cajas que necesitaba. Bueno, yo le dije el número de cajas que le iba a llevar.
Ok.
Era how many.
Okay.
I like that. Okay, Ana Beatriz con Claudio.
Where are you? I don't see you. Let me see. Okay, I got it.
Okay. Hi, Claudio. Where we place the merchandise? Does the juice arrive?
Hi, Beatriz. Can we store product in the basement?
Okay, Claudio. Who can will help you carry them?
Can we talk with logistics personnel?
Okay, thank you, Claudio. Finish the show.
Okay, thank you. Somebody else, please.
Me, teacher. Miss Jenny, Suleyma, and me.
Okay.
Okay. Okay. Hello, Miss Jenny.
Hello, Christian. I'm great. How are you?
I'm fine too. I want to ask you if you enter the merchandise to our warehouse.
What kind of product is it?
It sits a 10 pallet with washing machine.
Can I put the merchandising in the warehouse number one?
Yes, you can.
Okay.
Only that, teacher.
Excellent.
Thank you, Miss Jenny.
Thank you, please.
Okay. Somebody else, please. Me faltan varios. Me faltan la mitad casi. Por ahí los veo. Estoy dando tiempo para que cada quien diga, okay, I'm going to do it. Yeah, I don't want to push you. No quiero estar pushando a nadie. No. You are going to do it at the right moment that you want to do it, please. Hello. What about in case of Oscar and somebody else? I don't know if you want to. No sé si quieren hacerlo.
Sí. Excuse me. Yo tengo una, pero la podría compartir solo porque como con el otro compañero no pude señal buena, entonces no le escuchaba ni me escuchaba por rato. Pero sí tengo una pequeña. Y puedo compartir yo solo, no sé si no hay problema.
Okay, do it that way.
Okay. Compañero se llamaba Carlos, entonces yo puse can be two in cell and the 2 o'clock Carlos to reserve duty equipment now. Y iba a contestarme I can. Where can I put in the product? Y yo le respondía, on shell, no night. y él me respondía, ok, solamente eso puedo hacer, pero ya no lo, ya no pude tener comunicación con él.
Ok, causes the communication, ok.
Ok.
Ok, no problem, no problem. Somebody want to give a hand to Oscar or not? Alguien que le quiera ayudar a Oscar para que pueda hacer una conversación.
Si gusta, igual. La voy a hacer yo solo. ¿Verdad? Porque sí la tengo escrita.
Ah, ok.
Ok. Hello, I visit the delivery garden. Where can I store the new product? Hello, well, you can pile in the small boxes in the back room. Okay, perfect. And where I can the big boxes? You can the big boxes in the warehouse, the next building. Can you use the hand truck or platform truck? Yes, I can. Thank you. Only that.
Okay. Okay, 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 okay. Who is missing? Who is missing? Todavía me faltan, todavía me faltan. Por ahí lo veo que se me esconden así.
Juan Carlos, si quiere, comencemos.
Ah, Blanquita. Sí,
ya se animó.
Ya, ya se despertó.
Yo esperaba que se dijera y yo estaba esperando, pero no. La dama primero.
The ladies first.
Lady first.
Okay. Blanca, tomorrow arrives the new product from China.
Where can we place it?
We can put the new products in the warehouse.
It's okay.
It's right because it's a warehouse is safety.
Okay.
That's it, teacher.
Okay. Who is missing? Who is missing? Hay algunos que faltan todavía. ¿Quiénes son? ¿Quiénes son? Hola. Nadie falta, entonces. I don't believe you. Okay, let us try to do something different. Okay, hagamos algo diferente ahora. Ya no tenemos nada escrito. It's going to be based on the same idea. Va a ser relacionado con la misma idea. I need two volunteers. To volunteer that you are going to create a conversation from the beginning, saying hello, hey, hello, how are you, and you are going to pretend to look for somebody, for the manager or the company, or I don't know. I don't know if you understand what I'm trying to say. No sé si me comprenden la idea. Necesito a dos voluntarios que quieran hacer una conversación referente al mismo tema, pero en este caso uno es el que lleva el producto y anda buscando al gerente. Cuando ya lo encuentra, le pregunta dónde puede ubicarlo. Fácil, no nos complicamos. Solo dos para comenzar, no more than two. So only two, no more.
Estamos coordinando las ideas, teacher.
Ah, okay. When you speak English, you have a lot of ideas, and you never know which word are you going to use it. Y a veces no sabemos qué palabra es la que voy a usar, but suddenly all depends on how somebody starts. And that way I'm going to interact.
Teacher, I will try.
Maria Elena Guadalupe está ready.
Yes.
I need another volunteer. Necesito uno más. Solo uno.
I try, teacher.
Okay, Luis, Alfonso, okay. You are going to be the manager, Luis Alfonso. And Maria Elena is going to ask you some information. Okay, go ahead, Maria Elena.
Okay. Good evening, Luis Alonso. My name is Guadalupe.
Hi, Guadalupe.
In your company, where is the manager?
The manager is me.
Ah, nice to meet you. It's a pleasure. I go a product and I can say where I can place the product.
Where I can the product? Sorry, I don't understand.
She's asking you, she's asking you, ella le está preguntando, where, donde puede ella ubicar el producto.
Ah, okay. Please, bring the product in the administration, okay?
Ah, okay. Thank you.
You are welcome.
Oh.
Only that, teacher.
Yeah, simple. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Maria.
Thank you.
Okay, somebody else. Una pareja más. Only one. Ahorita los veo todos pensando, ¿lo hago o no lo hago? ¿Ya? Easy. Okay, before you leave, today I need to talk with Grisel. Yeah, today is, yeah, July 7th. Okay. Are you going to have time to talk with me? A few minutes, Grisel?
Okay.
Okay, I know that you understand, but maybe you have some question about something. Okay, but we are going to talk later on. Okay, let me see the attendance now because you don't want to, ya no quieren participar. Entonces, okay. Blanca Elizabeth is there? Let me see. Okay, Ana Beatriz?
Present.
Blanca?
Present, teacher.
Carlos?
Present.
Carlos Antonio?
Present.
Cristian Ernesto?
Present, teacher.
Claudio Iván.
Present, teacher.
Grisel.
Present.
Edwin Malmore Flores. No veo en ningún lado. Elmer. Amber. Elizabeth. It's not here. Gonzalo. Gonzalo. Luis Alfonso. Luis Manuel.
Present, teacher.
Okay, Luis Manuel. Maria Elena.
I'm here, teacher.
Thank you, Nelson. Nelson.
I'm here. I'm okay. Here.
Omar Francisco. Omar Francisco. No. Oscar Arnulfo.
Present, teacher.
Walter.
Present, teacher. Present, teacher.
Okay. Omar Francisco no me respondió, ¿verdad?
No, teacher. Sí.
Okay, six. Ana Judith. No está. Carlos Javier.
Present, teacher.
José Eduardo.
I'm here.
Okay. Carla Marisol. It's not here. Okay. Okay, before you leave, remember that the way how you are going to use can for information and for possibilities. Remember that if you are going to ask, if you need to have information, you are going to use a WH word at the beginning, and then you are going to use the can, and then you are going to use the personal pronoun and the complement. Where can I put this? Where can I stop this? Yeah, okay. And if you are going to ask questions, you are going to start with can you? Yeah, it's gonna be in that way. I don't know if you have any question about this topic. No sé si tienen alguna pregunta relacionada al tema que hemos visto hoy. Or everything is clear. O si todo está claro. Ok, antes de que se me vayan también, preguntarles si van haciendo ya las actividades en la plataforma.
Yes, teacher.
Yes, okay. Ok, write your hand if you
did. Yes, teacher. Activities.
Write your hand if you did.
Yes, I am.
The first one, please.
Sí, yo.
Solo tres la han hecho, mire. Solo tres, cuatro.
No, Pérez.
Cinco. Let me see. Los demás no encontraron la manito, se les perdió. Seis, seven, eight, and the rest. Siguen buscando la manito y no aparece. Okay, remember that you need to do it every day, please. ¿Por qué necesito que las vayan haciendo cada día? Porque ya el día sábado yo tengo que ir actualizando el cuadro. Entonces, yo lo hago generalmente el sábado en la mañana. Ya a las 9 de la mañana debe estar actualizado el cuadro de notas de cada semana. Si usted no lo tiene y lo hace después, ahí quedamos así como que no muy completo, porque yo debo ir entregando el cuadro semana por semana. Entonces les pido de favor que vayan haciendo todas las actividades en el tiempo pertinente para que así no corramos. Y acordarse que ya en la segunda semana hacemos el primer midterm, que sería ahí por el miércoles, me parece. Entonces ya debemos de haber solventado todos los ejercicios anteriores para poder responder al midterm. Ok, el tema de hoy fue no complicado, pero es de ponerle un poco de atención. If you don't have any questions, thank you very much. I hope to see you tomorrow. And don't forget to entering the platform and resolve the exercise that you have there. If you have any question, just write to the WhatsApp group that I can give you some advice how to solve the problems that you have. Okay, thank you very much. Okay, good night to all of you.
Thank you,
bye-bye.
Teacher.
Good night. Thank you. Good dreams, everyone. Bye-bye.
Bye, teacher.
See you.
See you tomorrow, teacher.
See you tomorrow.
Teacher, ¿quién se queda ahora? Ahora en la reunión, en la clase, después de la clase.
Excuse me.
¿A quién le toca ahora después de la clase?
Ahora le toca a Grisel.
Ah, okay, okay.
El día de mañana le tocaría a, ya le digo, el día de mañana sería a Claudio Iván.
Okay. Thank you, teacher.
Y en el caso suyo, Cristian, le doy su fecha si gusta.
Please.
Sí, Cristian, a usted le tocaría el viernes 9 de julio.
Excelente.
Así es que vaya listando de una vez las preguntas. Jenny todavía está por aquí. Jenny.
Sí, teacher, no escuché que me mencionara en la lista.
Jenny, a usted le toca el 22 de julio.
22.
Sí, el 22. Carlos Antonio Escobar is there too. Carlos. Antonio Escobar le corresponde el 19 de julio.
Ok, gracias, buenas noches.
Ok. Gracias.
Teacher, me escuché que va a mencionar en la lista.
¿A la hora de pasar la lista?
Sí, la última.
Uh-huh. Ok, let me see.
Solo para confirmar.
¿Y Grisel se me fue o quedó todavía ahí? No la veo.
Ya no la veo, pero aquí estaba.
Sí. Se fue. Let me see, Jenny. Yeah. Yeah, it's there.
Okay. Gracias.
Okay, okay, okay.
Good night.
Okay. Good night. Grisel, se fue. Okay, today I was waiting for Grisel. I talked with her about the 10 minutes. And she told me to be with me at the end of the class. I don't know, maybe something happened, the connection or something like that. But I'm here ready to explain something. Oh, well, I'm going to remember what we studied today. And in order to do it, I would like to show you something. In order to remember how you are going to do it. I want to show you is the structure in order that you can keep in mind how you are going to use. Can. Okay. If you are going to use can for information, you are going to put at the beginning a WH word question, and then you are going to use can. After that, you are going to use the personal pronoun and the complement. And that way you are going to use can in order to get information. And if you are going to talk about possibilities and you are going to ask a question, you are going to use can before. Then you are going to put the personal pronoun, and at the end you are going to add the complement. Es muy sencilla la forma de cómo usar can para sacar información. Ponemos una pregunta de una palabra de información que comienza con WH en este caso. Luego usamos can y luego el pronombre personal y el complemento. Y si vamos a hacer preguntas para ver la posibilidad que existe de algo, entonces usamos can primero. Después usamos el pronombre personal y luego el complemento. Creo que son ejemplos muy básicos y claros que son muy importantes para poder entender este tema. If you watch this video and you have some doubt, just please, you can write down to the WhatsApp group and I'm going to give you an answer. If you have any question, I'm going to be ready in the group in order to give you an answer. Okay, thank you very much. I hope to see you tomorrow. Have a good night. Bye-bye.